Welcome to Homeschool. We are with the second session on a chapter called Tissues. So in our previous class, we got to know what the tissue is. And later, we spoke about the different types of tissue, plant tissue, animal tissue. We started speaking about plant tissue. Under that, we completed the first variety of a plant tissue, that is the meristematic tissue, right? And now we will go for another type of a tissue called permanent tissue. Okay. So what do you mean by this permanent tissue? You know, these permanent tissues are present throughout the life of a plant, right? From, you know, birth to death of a plant, these tissues are present as it is inside a plant body. Okay. And they got a specialized cells which do a particular function. Clear? So permanent tissue has specialized cells. Okay? Different permanent tissue has got different specialized cells which can perform a specific function. Like a particular function. Okay. They have their own duties, guys. Okay. Each and every permanent tissue is going to do some duty within a body. Okay. Fine. And now this permanent tissue is again of two types. First one is simple permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissue. Okay. And second one is complex permanent tissue. Complex permanent tissue. Clear? And in today's class, we are actually going to discuss about simple permanent tissue. Okay. One brief introduction I will give about simple permanent and complex permanent. Clear? Simple permanent tissue means the tissue that is made up of same type of cells. It is tissue which consists of same type of cells. Okay? Complex permanent tissue means the tissue which has different type of cells. Okay. Say in simple permanent tissue, all cells are same. They have same structure. They look similar. They have same shape, everything. But in the complex permanent tissue, the cells that are present in a tissue, no, they are different. Okay, some cells are small in size, some cells may be big in size, right? The shapes of a cells also may be different from one another, like that. See, these simple permanent tissue contain the same type of cells. All cells have same size, all cells have same shape. But here in the complex, the tissue has a cells different types, like few are small, few are big, or few are very thin, few are very fat, like that. Clear? And in today's class, we are actually going to discuss about the simple permanent tissue. Okay? Listen, guys, simple permanent tissue is again divided into three types. Clear? The first one is parenchyma. The first one is parenchyma. Second type of a cell is collenchyma. All these names you have to remember. And the third type is sclerenchyma. Sclerenchyma. Okay. So about these guys, we are going to discuss one by one. Clear? So permanent tissues, two types. So simple permanent tissue means the tissue which consists same type of cells. What are they? Parenchyma, collenchyma, sclerenchyma. Okay, and now let us discuss about the parenchyma. Let us discuss about the parenchyma, the first variety. Okay, this parenchyma is a tissue which is present in almost all parts of a plant. You find this parenchyma in leaves, you can find it in stem region, you can find it in root region. Okay, so in every part of a cell, you will find the cells called parenchyma. Okay, and the parenchyma cells actually have thinner cell walls. They have thinner cell walls, guys. Okay, and they have larger vacuole. Larger vacuole. Okay, because actually the main function of parenchyma is to store food. Okay, so let me write that point. Very important. What is the main function? Main function of parenchyma is to store food. To store food. So, where is the food stored inside a cell? Vacuole. So, parenchyma cells have larger vacuoles. Clear? And one more thing is, parenchyma cells have many intercellular spaces. Many intercellular spaces. Okay? Clear? What do you mean by intercellular spaces, guys? The gap between the cells. Gap. Gap between cells is called intercellular spaces. Okay? Tissue means group of cells. Cells are arranged. Okay? Very neatly. Between the cells, whatever gap is there, no? That is actually called as intercellular space. Okay, and now say for example, if you say this is the stem, right? And if I cut the stem like this, okay, like I'm cutting like this, right? Say this is what? Say here if I see through microscope, you know, I have cut the stem like this and I am seeing it through microscope. This is what we actually call it as transverse section. So when I observe that transverse section under a microscope, you know, the cells looks like this. Right? This is one cell, this is another cell, this is the third cell, this is the fourth cell, like this. Okay? You see, the walls, cell walls or cell membrane is very thinner. Okay? And the guys will have a very large vacuole, nucleus. And this is vacuole, nucleus, like that. This is how the cells of parenchyma looks like under a microscope. So, what section? It is transverse section. Okay? But if I observe a longitudinal section, longitudinal section in the sense, like this I will cut a plant. Okay? Like this. Like this I am cutting, and this portion if I observe. Transverse section means this portion. I have cut like this and this portion I am observing. Longitudinal section in the sense, I have cut the plant horizontally and I am observing this section. Okay, so if I observe that section under a microscope, you know, this is how they look like. Okay, this is how they look like. And you will have this as a vacuole. So what is this? This is a vacuole. And you know, here you will have a nucleus. So what is this? Nucleus. Okay, so this is what, guys? This is actually a longitudinal section of parenchyma tissue. I'm observing parenchyma tissue looks like this, okay, in a transverse section. Parenchyma tissue looks like this in a longitudinal section. Clear, everybody? Okay. And actually speaking, there are two types of parenchyma. How many types, guys? Parenchyma, there are two types. Here I'll write. The first one is chlorenchyma. First one is chlorenchyma. Okay. So, these chlorenchyma, it is a type of parenchyma only. But along with the vacuole, nucleus, they have chloroplast. They also have chloroplast. Then that parenchyma tissue is called as chlorenchyma. Okay. So, what do you mean by chlorenchyma? It is nothing but the parenchyma which has which has chloroplast. Which has chloroplast. Okay. So, where is the chloroplast is used, guys? It is used for photosynthesis. Yes or no? What do you mean by photosynthesis? Plants prepare their own food. By a chemical reaction. So, how is that photosynthesis takes place? With the help of chloroplast. So, parenchyma tissue only. But in the parenchyma cells, along with the vacuole, this is a vacuole, this is a nucleus. So, along with this, if it has, chloroplast, if it has chloroplast, then it is actually called as chlorenchyma. Okay? And another type of parenchyma you will find, that is aerenchyma. Aerenchyma. Okay? So, what do you mean by aerenchyma? It is also nothing but a parenchyma which has, air bags or air spaces inside a cell. Okay, see, along with the vacuole, along with the nucleus, if it has air spaces, in this air spaces it will have. Okay, in this space the air is getting filled. Okay, and what is the duty of aerenchyma, guys? Usually, aerenchyma is found in aquatic plants. Aerenchyma is found in aquatic plants. So, what do? They help a plant to float. Okay, say we have observed many of the plants which stay in water is actually floating. What is the reason, guys? Because in them, there is a tissue called aerenchyma. Aerenchyma is nothing but parenchyma tissue only. Okay. But it has air spaces. The cells has air spaces, which is filled with air. Say, for example, you fill a balloon with air. Put it in a water. What you will observe? It floats. Okay. In a similar way, if a plant has aerenchyma, it floats in water. Because aerenchyma means having airbags inside parenchyma cells. Clear? So, what I will write here, what is its use? Aerenchyma is used for floating. Okay? It is used for floating. Or I can say, if something is floating on a water, that property is actually called as buoyancy. Okay? So, aerenchyma helps for buoyancy for a plant. Buoyancy means having an ability to float in a water. Clear, everybody? So, parenchyma, how the cells look like and what is the main use of parenchyma? And how does a transverse section looks like? And how is a longitudinal section looks like? And what are the two types of parenchyma? One is chlorenchyma, the other one is aerenchyma. What is the purpose of chlorenchyma? Photosynthesis. What is the purpose of aerenchyma? It is found in water plants, the plants which are there in water. And what is its purpose? It helps the plants to float in water. That property is called buoyancy. Clear? And now we will go for another type of simple permanent tissue, that is chollenchyma. Coming to the chollenchyma tissue, guys. You know, this chollenchyma tissue is found in a stalk of a leaf. Stalk of a leaf. Okay, below epidermis. Below epidermis. Say, epidermis in the sense it is like a skin of a plant, guys. You know, whatever you say, this is the stalk. Yes or no? Say, you can see, this is what we call it a stalk. And if you see this through a microscope, first you will find a skin cells. Like, first is a layer of a skin we have, even on a human body. The skin cells are actually called as epidermis. So below the skin, I mean in the stalk, this is a skin, outer layer is called as a skin. So after that skin inside, you will find collenchyma tissue, guys. Okay. And you know, this collenchyma, right here, found in, first you must know where it is found. Okay, parenchyma tissue is found in almost all the parts because these are the cells that store food, right? Almost all the parts need food for the growth and maintenance, isn't it? So parenchyma is present in all parts of a plant. But the collenchyma is found in a stalk of a leaf below the epidermis. Epidermis is just like a skin, guys. Skin of a plant parts, okay? And you know, the cells of collenchyma, cells have thickened corners, okay? Thickened corners, clear? Because why the corners are thick is because, you know, a chemical called cellulose and pectin is deposited, right? I will just show the cells of collenchyma here. Okay, see, I'm just drawing the cells of collenchyma. Imagine this is another cell, right? Cell walls, right? These are, you know, here the corners are there. No, the corners will be thicker, guys. This is one cell. The corner is very much thick. And here also the corner of a cell wall or cell membrane is very thick. You know, corners are thick. Like this. All corners, in all cells, you know, the corners are thick. This is what I mean by that point. Cells have thickened corners. Okay. So why actually the corners are thick, guys? See, this is what we call thickened. Thickened corners due to the deposition of, this is important, due to the deposition of a chemical called cellulose and pectin. What are these, guys? For your level, just try to remember, they are certain chemicals, okay, naturally available chemicals. So those cellulose and pectin is deposited at the corners, guys. Okay, so that's why you will find all thick corners. And as usual, you know, vacuole will be there. You know, this is vacuole and nucleus, right? And this is nucleus. Every cell has vacuole and nucleus. Vacuole and nucleus. Actually, this is transverse section of collenchyma. Okay, if you see a longitudinal section, you know, here these are the corners, right? So this is the corner of this cell, this is the corner of this cell, this is the corner of this cell, this is the corner of this particular cell. Corners will be thick, guys. Okay. And rest all, this is a vacuole and this is nucleus. Vacuole, nucleus. Okay. So what is this? Vacuole. This is nucleus. We all know plant cell has this vacuole, nucleus, cytoplasm and everything. You know, just see the corners. Cell wall corners are thick. Clear? So this is how the cells of collenchyma actually looks like. Okay, and this is your longitudinal section. You all know now what do you mean by longitudinal section and transverse section. Transverse section means if I cut a plant like this, that part I am observing. Longitudinal means if I cut a plant like this, that part I am observing longitudinally. Yeah, fine. So what is the duty of collenchyma? Duty in the sense, what is the function, guys? Collenchyma actually gives flexibility for the leaves or stem. Okay. So what I'll write here is collenchyma gives flexibility, okay, to leaf stalk. It is present in the leaf stalk. So in that region, it gives a kind of flexibility, fitness. It gives a fitness. Okay. So this colenchyma is responsible for the fitness of a plant. Okay. Say for example, this particular stem is there. The moment I do like this, it will not break, right? Actually, this is moving. Say when I move this leaf, it is not getting broken up because it is very much flexible. Say I can bend the small stems like this. I can bend, I can twist. You know, that is what we mean by flexibility. Clear? So leaves can move. They are very much flexible. They are not there as it is in the same position without any movement. Isn't it? They can move when a wind is blown, they can move on their own, right? So it is all because of colenchyma that is present in the leaf stalk, guys. That is actually giving flexibility. That colenchyma tissue is giving fitness or flexibility for the plant parts. So where and all flexibility is required for a plant part, you know, there the colenchyma tissue would be there. Remember, how does the cells of colenchyma look like? They are normal cells, okay? But only thing is they have thickened corners, guys, okay? Because of this chemical present. What is the chemical? Cellulose and pectin. Actually, these chemicals are only giving flexibility. That chemical is responsible for the flexibility, okay? So since that chemical is there in those cells at the corners, you know, colenchyma cells help in giving flexibility to the plant body. It may be a leaf stalk or smaller stems, whatever. Okay. And one more thing, less intercellular spaces are observed. What do you mean by intercellular spaces, guys? See, in the parenchyma, when I have drawn a parenchyma transverse section, I have drawn like this. There is a gap, you know, this is the gap between this cell, this and this. This is the gap between the cells. And such gaps are actually very less between the cells of colenchyma. Parenchyma, you will observe large intercellular spaces. But in colenchyma, the space between the cell is very less, guys. Because the corners have become very thick, no? Actually, the spaces between the cell is also very less. Clear? So, these are the points that you need to remember about colenchyma. Next, we will go for sclerenchyma. Coming to sclerenchyma, guys. Sclerenchyma is actually a tissue that contains or that consists of dead cells. You know, all the cells that are present in sclerenchyma are dead cells. They are not the living cells, guys. Clear? So usually these sclerenchyma cells, you know, the walls of the cells are actually thickened with a chemical called lignin. The walls of cells are thickened. Okay, the walls are very thick. Why? Because of a chemical called lignin. So walls of a cell is thickened with a chemical. Remember this word, chemical called, what chemical, guys? It is lignin. Lignin, very important word, lignin. Okay, it is also called as cementing material. You know cement, how hard it is. It is not the cement actually. Say like it has properties of cement. Cement becomes very hard, isn't it? So this lignin is also of that type of hardness. It has that type of hardness. Okay, fine. And now, let me draw the transverse section and longitudinal section of sclerenchyma so that you will get some idea. Okay, say if these are the transverse section cells. Okay, say I'm drawing like this. Cell walls. okay, transverse section. And see here, this is what the cell wall, no? See, these walls are actually very thick. The walls, you see, I'm using this red color pen to show that thickness, right? All the walls, it becomes very thick, guys. Okay, so this particular thickened wall is due to all this is lignin. Okay, so lignin is present everywhere. Because of this lignin, you know, the walls are very, very, very thick. Clear? So this is what? Lignin layer. Lignin layer. And the cells are dead cells. And this is actually transverse section of sclerenchyma. If I have to show the longitudinal section, you know, just I'm showing thick walls. Okay. Like this. Thick. This is, if you see the cell in a longitudinal section, longitudinal way, you know, this is how it looks like. Okay. So, the cell wall is very much thick, guys, because of the deposition of which chemical? Lignin. And now, let us try to discuss about the function of sclerenchyma. What is the function? It actually gives, you know, sclerenchyma cells gives strength and support to the plant body. Strength and support to the plant body. Yes or no? Say for example, if somebody comes and hit us, what do? We keep standing there only? No, right? We will run and go off. But plants cannot run and go, no? If somebody hits a plant, you know, which will protect, you are hitting a bark. Bark is very hard. Nothing will happen to the internal structure of a plant, right? Because, you know, the plant cells, outermost plant cells are very much hard. The hard is due to the presence of sclerenchyma tissue. Okay. So, where and all the harder portions are there in a plant? You know, there actually sclerenchyma is there. See, big plants, the bark portion, very hard. Yes or no? So, all that is actually a dead tissue. It contains a dead cells. All of them are sclerenchyma cells. Why? You know, how come it is giving strength and support? It's because of this hard chemical present. Which is that chemical? Lignin. Lignin. Remember the name, guys. Very, very important. Clear? And now, where is this sclerenchyma found? It is found in bark of a big tree. It can be found in stem region. Okay, stem region sometimes. And you know, hard coverings of seed, nuts, etc. Okay, say for example, outer covering of coconut. Coconut covering is very hard. We have to hit it to break. You know, what is that shell of a coconut is made up of? It is completely made up of sclerenchyma tissue, guys. Okay, see, the cells of sclerenchyma tissue, which has a chemical called lignin. That's the reason it's very hard. Clear? So, outer covering of coconut. You know, these are the areas where you can observe the sclerenchyma tissue. Clear, everybody? So, that's all about simple permanent tissue. Discussed about parenchyma, collenchyma, sclerenchyma. Remember, where are they present? What is their function and how their cells look like? Clear? In my next video, let us discuss about the other type of permanent tissue of a plant, that is complex permanent tissue. Till then, keep revising your concept and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Like, share and subscribe our channel for more updates to learn the concepts in an easier way and in a detailed way. Thank you so much.